Salute, comrades, and welcome back to Let's Play Master of Orient 2 Battle at Antares. My name is Vadim, and today we are going to start a new colony and a totally new star system. So, yeah, our colony ships have arrived, and this is a rich planet with heavy gravitation and max population of 30. You see, 30. This is how big this planet will be. So this is our ships sitting down, and this is will be let's see. Okay, Sochi. It's our great south town city where the winter winter Olympic Games will took place. So we have no time to waste, so we will buy a factory there. So new contact with humans. And you will see how bloodthirsty they are in a second. No, not in a second, but very soon. So we have our first research treaty with them, soon we will be able. Okay, so. Yeah, I've just made it in time to colonize this planet, this star system. So let's explore even further. So some management, and we'll continue. Yeah, another poor, no, not very good. Cannot. Let's go here. So for now it will be just nothing really will happen, but I won't cut this out, because I want to show you all the steps of the process. And I need a freighter fleet, so I guess we will do it soon, very soon. Because without freighter fleets, our colonies will be starving, and will not have enough food. So we will freighter fleets. It's good that don't take lots of industrial production to create this fleet. Sorry. So another Mega Wells leader. Okay, we will buy him soon. So next, silicoids. This is, as I've said, the terror of the of this galaxy, of the Master of Orient, because we cannot propose a treaties to them, so he can attack whoever he wants. And he is a good productionist. He can he is dangerous. And by the way, he has only one star system. It's surprising, because in the beginning of the game everybody was given a colony ship, so he could colonize any nearby star system, and he don't have any colonized star system. So either he in the war, or he put it in the on the planet with monsters attached to them, and he didn't make it. But it's highly unlucky, because computer opponents know where the troubles are, so they don't send their colony ships to this type of planet. Colony base, yeah. So we are developing, and we starting new colonies. I really should buy this leader that I have. So another colony ship. So soon it will, we will become a lot bigger. And by the way, I need to... Some random events, nothing special. I really need to discover enemy or gnomes. Yeah, Silicoids are in war with gnomes. I really need to discover the... to scout their enemy star system, so I would know what defenses they have. Not just now, but in future too. So this yet don't have any defense, but I have no ships to attack. And I really don't want to attack it yet. Maybe a little bit later. So, an Mirkulite missile. This is my goal here. Another race, let's make a treaties with them. Oh, exchange tech, hydroponic farm, excellent, excellent. This will be a revolution, the farming revolution, soon, very soon. So right now I'm in peace almost with everybody, and I don't really need any fleet. No, I don't need him. It's the point that some of the enemy, not enemy, but some of the leaders that come to you and offer their help, they sometimes have an research that they give you for free. So you hire this command leader and you automatically discover this research. But the game usually don't tell you that this commander have a research attached to him. So it's and then even after you buy him, you don't even know that that you've received the research, and sometimes you just discover that for instance you suddenly know how to terraform your colonies, your planets. So we've discovered the deuterium fuel cells, so we can research even further in galaxy. Another planet. Colony base. Good. Everything goes. Just as supposed to be. We will even transport one of them. Worker. Oh, yes, about worker, we can transport them from one planet to another, from one star system to another. It takes time, slow, but Space Dragon, excellent. My scout ship is lost immediately. You will see, this is another type of space monster, and I have no time to do anything. So, but maybe later I will come there. And and do something about it and colonize Hispania. But okay, we have another our colony ship ready. I will send him to found another our colony. Our borders slowly expanding. So, but for now, comrades, I guess that's it, and you are dismissed.